No, no, no! Don't come over here. It's over.
Hey, what's going on, guys? Joey from Stampede Gaming. And that's right, if you guys missed it, I had the clip right there ready for you guys. Toad Warpin just beat Battletoads on NES not too long ago. Congratulations, Phil. I saw you've been trying for a while there, I think dating back from like, I think September of last year. But it was actually, honestly, it was really, really good to see you get through that game. Sometimes I take for granted how hard Battletoads is for a first-time player. And sometimes I forget like how hard these games were the first time you played them. Because you know, since then, playing them so often, I guess they don't become as hard anymore. And then you underestimate how hard they are until you know either A, you're a first-time player playing it, or B, you go back to it after a long time and be like, oh wow, I forgot how hard this game was, right? I remember beating Battletoads way back when. My first time beating it was, I didn't even remember the date too, October 16, 2014. The reason why is because I was just really, really competitive when it came to gaming. And, you know, I was always told how, like, you do any research on it, Battletoads is always like, considered the hardest NES game, and I wanted to be like, no, I want to beat this game. People say it's the hardest one, I want to beat it, you know? So I set forth to beat it, I remember, like I said, October 16, 2014. And I remember after I beat it, I was like so thrilled. I said to myself, I beat the hardest game that people say is the hardest NES game of all time. My confidence level was like through the roof, you know? I feel like I always said to myself, any NES game that I come across, I can beat now, because if I can beat Battletoads, I can beat anything. My confidence level was just right up here. And that only lasted for a couple of months. December of that year, I got introduced to a game that really humbled me. So it's December between the 25th and New Year's. The 31st, so I think one of those days that don't matter. Me and my friend Alex, actually, we went to go see one of his friends who just so happened, his name happened to be Alex as well. And he is a video game collector, like really hardcore. Like his game is like, it's also like full of games. You know, you go to his bedroom, video games. You go to the living room, video games. You open the fridge, video games. So we weren't there, believe it or not, to play video games. We were just there just to chill and drink and stuff, right? And I remember I had to brag about my Battletoads victory, and he said, oh, you beat Battletoads. I'm like, yep. He's like, so you think it's the hardest NES game? I'm like, well, people say it is, so and yeah, it was pretty challenging, so yeah, I'd probably say it was. Like, yeah, well, I guarantee you I got a game that you've never beaten before, and it's harder than Battletoads. And I'm like, bring it on, come on, I can beat Battletoads, I can beat anything. So he lays this game upon me, and I take it home, and the game kicked my ass. To the point where I didn't see anywhere near the later levels. I got defeated. And it really bothered me because, you know, here's the thing with the game, okay? It's a bad game. And I could always say to myself, you know, I can get even people that could even probably say to me if they want, oh, well, don't worry about it. I mean, it's not your fault. It's a bad game, right? But see, here's the thing. I don't like making excuses. I beat Battletoads on NES. I should be able to beat anything. Anything I want, I should be able to beat it. So, I ended up giving the game back to the guy and said, you win, I can't beat it. And that was honestly, it was a tough pill to swallow because I don't like to lose. I hate it. know, whenever you have a video game, you want to beat the game. You don't want the game to beat you. So I lost, and it was a bitter pill to swallow. And here we are, 10 years later, almost 10 years later. I would like to think I've done some pretty good stuff in video games since then. You know, I've done a Red Swayze challenge, Ninja Turtles 1. I've beaten Contra Alien Wars on hard mode, NDR. I've also done the NDR with Mega Dan co-op NDR. I've also done NDR of Battletoads since then. I'd like to think that maybe I'm an above average gamer. 6 out of 10. Can I get a 6? I'll be happy with a 6 out of 10. So I said to myself, you know what, this year, I know I got some time to spare. I got some time to play some video games. I want to try to beat this game now. It's been haunting me for 10 years, and I want to put it to rest. This is a game, let's talk about it for a second. So basically, this game gives you 3 lives and no continues. That's what you got to deal with, okay? There's like these candy bars in the game, and for every 5th candy bar you grab, you get a 1-up, which is helpful. The problem is though, when you die, there's no checkpoints by the way, so when you die, you go back to the beginning of the level. The candy bars that you picked up, they're gone. They don't respawn, so you can't farm lives. That would have been helpful, but you can't do that. There's no life bar. You know, 1-hit kills. You know, you fall into a pit, death, you know, you hit an enemy, dead. And this game suffers. Well, put it this way. What makes the game really bad is the jumping, okay? It's a platformer. So as a platformer, you really gotta rely on your jumping to get you through the levels. The game suffers from what I like to call Ghost and Galvanitis, where when you make a jump, no matter what direction you're at, you're committed to that direction. You can't steer yourself. So that makes it difficult. And the other thing too is the fact that, you know, those jumps you get in video games, you get those really tough jumps where it's like you gotta jump from like the edge of one platform and it's gotta be like pixel perfect, edge of one platform, and you barely make it to the next platform. You get at least one of those in like some challenging games. You get one in, you know, it's like level 8 of Super C, you get one. You get one in Cypher's Path on Castlevania 3, you get those hard jumps. There's like almost every jump in this game is like that, where you have to make a really hard jump on a small platform. And to make matters worse, guys, the jump, it feels like, I can't even say it feels like, it is. You basically have auto fire on A. So I don't know why the game was designed like that, but it's like, I never realized before when I made jumps, like in good games like Mario or Mega Man or Super C, that when I'm jumping, I'm actually holding down the jump button until I actually land. And I think I do that because I want to make sure I get the full extent of the jump, right? So when I'm landing, I'm still holding on to the A button, but then I'm obviously releasing so I can continue playing the game, right? When you do that in this game, if you're holding on to that A button, because it's auto fire, you're just continuously jumping. And it's messing you up because you're not meaning to jump. And it's like, oh crap, I'm holding down the jump button. Oh my god, it's such a terrible game. And again, it's because of the bad controls, the bad platforming. But I don't care. You know, I want to beat it. I guarantee you, nobody in the retro gaming community has ever beaten this game. And it's not something that you can put on your resume or anything. And it's not that, oh, I'm saying I'm better than anybody. No. It's that no one wants to waste their time playing this game because it's such a bad game. This is a game that I need to put it to rest. It's been haunting me for 10 years. And it's time to, you know, buckle down. And I want to beat this game now. This game is Linus Spacehead. No, it's not a joke. I'm serious. This is the game. This is the game that I'm going to be beating. It's a bad fucking game.
No. Fuck me. Thank you. I'm not even hitting him. What the fuck is going on here? Thank you. Motherfucker! Just fucking turn around! Oh, motherfucker! The one time I need to fucking miss that pixel. Come on, baby. No! Thank you. Somehow I'm still alive. Son of a bitch! I'm right fucking there, man. Fucking double team, I can't do anything there. Fucking piece of shit! Thank you. fucking just go there? Yes. Come on, yes! Oh my god.